Okay, so there's no guarantee in anything when you go to a coding bootcamp. Make sure to watch the whole video. I'm going to be talking about why bootcamp grads can't get jobs, what are some things that are in their control that they can do to help, and then what are things that are out of their control. Before we get started, I wanted to give a huge shout out to Emmanuel Rouse. I made a video called Things I Wish I Knew Before I Went to Coding Bootcamp, and this was one of his comments. So he said, "Wow, I needed this. I'm 2 months from my estimated graduation date for my coding bootcamp, and I feel so behind and lost on a lot of the topics that I've learned. I'm going to keep going though and get through this alive." So when I went through coding bootcamp, I definitely felt completely lost too, and I'm pretty sure most of the other people in my cohort did, so it's totally normal when you're going through the process. My goal is to share some things that I've learned to help people break into tech without as many issues. If I had known some of these things beforehand, it would have made everything a lot easier. I'm putting out new videos every single week, so make sure to hit that subscribe button. And also, if you can leave a like on this video, that would help a ton. Okay, so this video is broken down into two parts: things that you can control in the process of getting a job and things that you can't control. So the bootcamp I went to was Hack Reactor in San Francisco back in 2018. Now there are some outcome statistics released by a council called the CIRR. And back in 2018, the job search placement rate in 6 months actually dipped a lot. So if this industry has such a high demand for workers, then why aren't people getting jobs? Let's jump into the things that are out of people's control when they're trying to get a job. So first off, the job market might not just have enough jobs for junior engineers, or there are too many boot camps pushing out people who are then looking for junior jobs. It pretty much comes down to a supply and demand issue from one sense. And from what I've read online and seen anecdotally, take this with a grain of salt, there is a higher demand for senior engineers and mid-level engineers and less of a supply for those than there are for junior engineers. Now for junior positions, you're basically competing with college kids. These are kids who probably have had internship experience and also have had 4 years of time studying, which for a bootcamp grad, you've only probably had 3 to 6 months of time and zero internship experience in that field. There is also bias in the industry against bootcamp grads. I wouldn't necessarily take it off your resume, but it's probably not the thing to put on the top of your resume. You see all the time on Reddit posts, people bashing others for going to coding bootcamps. I don't think all coding bootcamps are bad. Some are great, some have excellent curriculums, and some really do work for a lot of people. Another thing potentially out of your control is just the demand in jobs in the area that you're searching in. So if you're in somewhere like San Francisco, yes, there are a lot of jobs, but there's also that supply and demand issue where there are a lot of people looking for jobs. If you were to go someplace like LA, there might be, you know, a lot more openings for people in junior positions. But if you were to go to a random city in the middle of nowhere, there probably aren't that many open positions for tech. If a place isn't well known for tech, I would argue that you might have a harder time and there might be a lot less accessibility to get a tech job, especially if it's your first one. Same potentially goes for a place that has a huge tech scene. If you're in a place like San Francisco where the competition is insanely high, it might be pretty challenging to get a job as well. These are just my thoughts, they're not necessarily backed up by facts, but I do think location does play into whether people get jobs or not. Okay, so these are the things that you can control. I did see other people in my cohort who made some mistakes in getting their job search, and I do think that this delayed their progress by a lot. So the first one is resume prep. I do think that your projects are going to be your experience when you're applying for your first job. You probably should list these as far up as you can. Now, when talking about your technical projects, I think it's good to have a mix of front-end projects, back-end projects, and full-stack projects that show a range of your abilities. When talking about technical topics, you should basically answer these questions. Number 1, what did you build? Number 2, what technologies did you use? And the most important one is number 3, what the technical benefit was of both the technologies you implemented and what you actually built. If you can communicate these well on a resume and also have a decent amount of good projects, this will go a long way. Number 2, taking a vacation after the bootcamp. Personally, I saw people in my cohort take 1 to 2 months off after the bootcamp, and I truly think that does stunt their progress. So coding is one of those things that practice does make perfect, and having exposure to that almost every single day will really keep you up to date with your skills. If you take 2 months off, especially after only having 3 to 6 months of study time, you'll probably forget a lot of it. Now, I'm not saying a break is bad. It's definitely worth taking, you know, a few days off to a week or maybe 2 off between the coding bootcamp and when you start your job search. But ultimately, if you take more than that off, you'll pretty much screw up the rhythm. Number three is you really have to want this. You truly do get out of the coding bootcamp what you put into it, as well as afterwards in the job search. So if you're only giving it half effort, you probably won't do that well in the job search. This kind of comes back to the reason of why you went to the coding bootcamp in the first place. If you really don't have a great reason why, or you really don't like technology, again, you probably won't do well in the job search. Number four is that you just need more practice. 3 to 6 months of the coding bootcamp really is not that much time to get good at your skills. So in the job search, you should also be focusing on studying and building at least one side project. This will keep your skills pretty sharp, and also it will sharpen your algorithm and thinking skills. One great thing to do is to do 1 to 2 algorithm problems every single day and just make it a habit. Yes, they're not necessarily the funnest thing in the world, but if you can make it a habit to just do a few a day, you'll really see a lot of progress over the long term. Okay, and the last, probably most important one that I can't stress enough is you just have to apply to more jobs. This is something I also noticed in college as well. A lot of people just thought they could apply to a handful of jobs and they would magically be given one. And I got kind of caught up in this mindset too. It's a little bit of entitlement where you think that you've already done something so you deserve a job. And that's really not the way to go about it. It is the hard truth, unfortunately, but that's the world we live in. And what you need to do is just stay focused and apply a lot. The more you increase your numbers as well as your interviewing skills, the higher chance of success that you'll have. Now you'll see some arguments that people say this is not a numbers game. I truly do believe that the more you get yourself out there, the more you will increase your chances. And that's pretty much what it comes down to. Just don't forget that you also have to increase your algorithm skills as well as interviewing skills as you apply to more jobs. This will truly increase your chances. The more rejections you get, the closer you are to success, as long as you're continuously improving. So in the job search, just remember there are things that are out of your control. Let's say you get to an onsite and you put in a ton of work and they ultimately don't go forward with you. It might have been something that was totally out of your control. The interviewer might be having a bad day, they might change their budgeting, they might have gone with someone else for some arbitrary reason. Don't beat yourself up. Take everything you've learned from that and apply that to the next ones. If you enjoyed this video, please subscribe. It helps a lot. And also check out this video on my story around my job search after the coding bootcamp. New videos every single week. Thank you.